Hello, and welcome to the webinar on AI-powered valve design. We will be starting with the webinar now. First of all, thank you for joining. I'm Subhranshu, and I will be conducting today's 45 minutes long webinar. We will be having a question answer session at the end of the presentation. So whenever you come up with a question, I would suggest you to please use the chat window to put up all your questions. We will be answering them at the end of the session. Also, please stay tuned to the end of the presentation. We have a special of enterprise account offer for free, and I will be sharing the instructions for that at the end of the presentation. So let me begin with the presentation now. I will just repeat once. If I am not audible to you, please let me know. We will figure out the reason behind it. I'll just hang on for a couple of minutes. Please let me know if I am not audible to you. All right. I'm audible to my colleague, so I'm proceeding ahead. So the overview of the presentation would be, we will first go through the concepts involved in flow performance testing. Then we will have a look at the best possible way to perform flow loop testing using computers, that is digitally. Later on in the presentation, we will deep dive into the AI-powered application and we'll understand how we built it. So let me first introduce you, CCTech to you. CCTech's leadership team consists of Sandeep Zadav, Vijay Mali, and Naim Kumar. They are all alumni of IIT Bombay. We have a 50-plus developers team having expertise in CAD software development, CFD automation, machine learning, augmented reality, and more. Moving ahead, and this is me. I have been working with CCTech for more than 6 years now. I lead the research activities at CCTech, and I lead the marketing of SimulationHub application as well. You may reach me using the provided details. So Sandeep is having a busy year presenting this work at the global stage. This work has been presented at all these international conferences and have received a great appreciation. It was demanded by many of them to have an online presentation, and here we are doing it. So let us begin the technical presentation with the basics. The primary parameter that we calculate under flow performance study is valve flow coefficient, that is CV or KV as it is denoted in SI units. CV is the measure of flow passing through a valve when a specific pressure condition is maintained across it. Mathematically, it is a volume of water that flows through a valve in 1 minute when 1 psi pressure drop is maintained across it. If we know this value for a valve, we can easily find out how much flow would pass through the valve for a specific pressure drop. Or else, we can find out what amount of pressure drop needs to be maintained in order to pass a specific amount of flow through the valve. Now, hydrodynamic torque is the second important parameter under the flow performance studies. So hydrodynamic torque is the amount of turning moment experienced by the shaft purely due to the forces of the fluid on the rotating body of the valve. It may be a disc or a ball valve or a plug valve. So these components are experiencing a pressure due to the flow of fluid, and that unbalanced forces induce a torque in the shaft. Now this torque about the shaft plays an important role in selecting and sizing of the actuator. In flow performance studies, hydrodynamic torque is calculated and presented in the form of hydrodynamic torque coefficient. If you concentrate on its formula, you will find that CDT comes out to be a dimensionless number. Now we know that the three most widely used CV calculation methods in the industry are the laboratory flow loop testing, then Excel-based calculators, which reduce a lot of time and at the same moment, it also reduces a bit of accuracy. But then comes computational fluid dynamics, which is highly accurate to compare to experimental flow loop testing, but it also comes with a lot of skill sets and expertise needed for CFD. But let me introduce you to a whole new CFD software that we have created. That's called simulationHub. I will be talking a bit about simulationHub Valve CFD application as the AI powered wall design application could have taken ages if simulationHub application was not used in its development phase. So simulationHub Valve CFD is one of its kind fully autonomous Valve CFD software. It follows the same ANSI standard for valve capacity testing procedure. A valve designer opens the CAD model of our valve design inside simulationHub and with a few clicks gets the highly accurate CV calculated within an hour. It's just 1 hour time. So that's the major difference of simulationHub versus other CFD softwares. It's a fully autonomous software, so just few clicks and you get the accurate CV within an hour. Let me quickly show you a demo of this application. So here we are creating a simulation. That's a project. We will be demoing on a 100 DN100 globe valve. There are many different simulations available in our simulation gallery. If you visit simulationhub.com, you will get to see all of them. What we did right now is we uploaded the CAD model to simulationHub. Now we will be specifying some inputs like it's a flow regulation type of valve or isolation valve. Is it a linear valve or rotation valve? Then some other inputs like the side diameter, the pipe schedule, pressure class, material and all. Very few inputs we just need to set up. So we will proceed with selecting the moving components of the valve. So first we will select the moving component here. Now the moving component needs an axis to move, right? So we will be also identifying the axis about which it will rotate or lift, either cases. Yeah. So now the axis and moving components are available. So we will try to set up the start position and end position. It's a linear motion valve, so we saw a linear movement in the preview. Now that's saved in the setup. Now we will go and select which side is our upstream side and which side is our downstream side. So the inlet and outlet is being specified here. That's all the setup that we need to do in simulationHub. Now we will just submit the simulation into our cloud servers and all eight openings that we mentioned will be calculated parallelly on heavy HPC computers on the cloud, and quickly within an hour's time we will be getting the results ready. So once the results are available, it was a quick demo, so we got it very quickly. So once the results are available, we will have the results tab activated in our product. And first I am demonstrating the results of performance curves. This is for CV curve. You can export the curve in any format you want, Excel or image. Similarly, now we are going towards some qualitative results. Here we are seeing the flow lines. Now what I did is I changed the opening condition and showing a more open condition results. Now the more flow will pass in the valve. Now I'm representing the cut sections for the results that we did. I can change the cut sections from velocity to pressure. These are the two type of properties we are displaying as results. So it's a complete repository of all the simulations inside a browser. And it's available forever with the account, the user's account. It will be always available in your results. The interesting part is we have created a complete detailed CFD report, a PDF file. This file, at the same time the simulation completes, will be sent to you through mail. So all this in just 1 hour, that's the power of simulation app. Okay, just hold on everyone. My PowerPoint has crashed. I will get back to you in just a minute. Yeah, we are back with the presentation. Let me start sharing the screen for you. We were at the demo, so moving on to the next slide. Yes. So here is a comparison of traditional CFD software versus simulation hub. So if you go the traditional CFD way, you will need a high expertise in CFD software. There is a lot of manual process involved in this method. Then the softwares run on local and desktop machines. So you need an in-house SPC for that. This, since the process is highly manual, so you will need a lot of time to also do the pre-process and the post-process of the simulation. The results would be available in days, and it would cost a lot because the software licensing is also heavy. When we go for Simulation Hub, it's in a cloud product, so and an automated product as well. So all it needs is to upload a geometry and leave the rest to us. It gives results in less than an hour, and the price is also just $50 for one valve. Flow performance of one valve can be calculated in just $50. So that's the benefit. Now, since this is a new CFD software, a lot of questions would arise, like what's the validation and how is the accuracy of this product. So let me share you some results here. Here is an example case that we validated our results with. As you see, the results obtained from Simulation Hub are in the plus or minus 5% error band. This was a public data, publicly available experimental data that we compared with. Let me also show you some validation studies that were performed for our customers. I will not share the names as it is supposed to be, but the app was able to predict highly accurate results for both the cases here. If you see the error, it's below 2% from the experimentally calculated flow performance values. Now I have a customer success story here. So we have a write-up here. I will just share the write-up with you. A major advantage of virtual flow loop testing using Simulation Hub Valve CFD is that it makes CFD simulation and predicting CV values an integral part of your valve design process. Here is a case of one of our customers who wanted to make extensive design changes to achieve the target CV of 120,000 from the initial 93,000. As you can see, the first design that they submitted for simulation into Simulation Hub gave a resultant CV of just 93,000. They were expecting, they had designed CV of 120,000. So they were able to perform design changes and predict the CV for their updated design within merely 3 hours. This wouldn't have been possible if they had to perform an actual flow loop testing or use the traditional CFD methodologies. And we believe that This is where the simulation of Valve CFD application plays a major role, as it reduces significant time from the CV prediction process while maintaining a good accuracy. One more point to notice is that the cost involved in this whole design optimization study is just $80. So in 3 hours and just $80, the customer was able to find the final design which will give this required CV. An interesting case, I would say. So apart from this, we are also working on cavitation physics, and SimulationHub will be coming up with high fidelity features in cavitation physics, like onset of cavitation, calculation of cavitation index and pressure recovery factor. Then also complete simulation of bubble formation and implosion. So all of this will be coming up in our later releases in simulation. So that was a quick overview of what flow performance testing is all about and how it can be accurately calculated. Now that SimulationHub has reduced this time to 1 hour, can this be further accelerated using AI, like say 1 second? Let me put up a question even bigger than this. For a desired CV requirement, can AI assist me to find the perfect valve geometry? So we started with a problem definition to predict a valve design that satisfies these four criteria. Desired flow coefficient that will be provided by the user of this application. The design should have lowest torque coefficient and should weigh as low as possible. The last objective is specific to triple offset butterfly valve. It is a geometric misconfiguration due to which the valve design becomes non-functional. We will discuss more about this after a couple of slides. This slide again describes the same problem definition in a more graphical way. So moving ahead quickly, I'd first like to introduce a bit of concept of machine learning. So in a layman's understanding, I will explain what machine learning is. So in traditional programming approach, what we do is we take some data, then write a program around it and ask the computer to run the program or execute the program and calculate the output for us. Whereas in machine learning approach, we take lots of historical data along with the respective outputs or say observations and ask the computer to identify the program for us. In a more mathematical language, we ask the computer to fit a curve for the given data to output mappings. Now, once the program is identified by the computer, we ask the computer to predict the output for any new given data. This is the fundamental difference between traditional programming and machine learning. Let me now show you a quick demo of the application that we have already built, and then we will understand what went into its making. So I hope that all of you are able to see my Chrome browser window. This is the single page application that is hosted at experiments.simulationhub.com. Here we have already implemented and uploaded the ML models for two of our butterfly valves, and we are also coming up quickly on the other type of valves. So first I will show you a quick demonstration of how quickly actually AI is predicting the CV of any design. So in a triple offset butterfly valve, I will quickly change the axial offset value from 15 mm to let's say 20 mm and see instantly the new CV was predicted. And we see that prediction was just took 0.05 seconds. It's taking more time to create the geometry from in our server. So I can just play around with this tool and see, as I was talking, there is some interference concept in triple offset valve. I will ignore it for now. We will talk in details about it. So whenever I change the parameters, quick results are predicted on the screen. Let's see an example of how sensible it makes to us. Let's say in the case of concentric butterfly valve, I want to have a valve design wherein it should have the maximum CV value. So if I want to have that kind of a prediction, that kind of a design, so I'm just sliding the curve and setting it to have the maximum CV. So this was the reverse problem I tried. I set the desired CV and asked ML model to come up with a design. So as you can see, the most efficient design wherein we get the maximum flow through a valve for a given pressure drop would be a simple thin disc. So that's what it is. If I go for a more interesting CV profile, more realistic one, then we would get a different valve design. Yeah, this looks more like a concentric butterfly valve. Let me show you some more examples in triple offset butterfly valve. So you would be wondering what happens if I give some desired CV values which are not feasible or not realistic to manufacture such kind of a curve, if I am asking. So what our model is doing is it's understanding that it is not feasible and it's giving a best fitting curve out of this the blue line. Out of the blue line I expected, it's showing a red line which is the actual CV for the calculated design that will give me a best fitting results. So going back to a realistic curve, I will just create a better curve this time. So let's say my CV requirement is such that I am not expecting a very high CV, but I am using a flow control type of application wherein I need to maintain such kind of a flow performance. So I am getting a pretty accurate flow performance. Let me just play it a bit more. So this one is a more fitting curve. So this design would be what I would be choosing. Now, what is the point about multiple objective criteria? So here what we gave is we gave 5 different design options to the user of this application where they are ordered in a descending order of in ascending order of mass, that is the weight of the valve, or in terms of hydrodynamic torque coefficient. So when I select the lowest mass design, then the the hydrodynamic torque coefficient increases. If I go for a lower hydrodynamic torque coefficient, then the mass increases a bit. But this seems to be a better design overall compared to the first one, the lowest mass one. So I would rather prefer to go with this design. Now what I can do is I can just simply download this geometry. This will be downloaded in a step format. Here I can just show you the window. Yeah, this is the window. The step file is ready to download. I can download and open it in my favorite CAD modeling software, or else I can also download the parameters, that is a CSV file which contains all the inputs of the geometry as well as the flow performance coefficient and hydrodynamic torque coefficient. So this was it about the current state of the application that we have created. We are working on other valve types. We will be uploading them quickly. And going ahead with the presentation, I will switch back to the slides. Okay. So let me talk a bit about the design principles of a butterfly valve. This presentation is highly focused on the butterfly valve because the work that we done was on two types of butterfly valves. So let us briefly understand the complexities involved in designing a butterfly valve. As we know, we have 3 design principles of butterfly valve. These days even a 4th offset is coming into market. Still, the major ones are the concentric butterfly valve, that's on the left hand side of the picture, the double offset butterfly valve, it's the center one, and the high performance triple offset butterfly valves. Now the last one is a pretty complex design, as it involves an offset in the cone angle along with the standard axial and radial offset. When I'm talking cone angle, I'm talking about the seat and seal connecting surfaces. So that is in the shape of a inclined cone. So that's a pretty complex geometrical feature. Now going ahead, this is the slide I was referring since some time back. In triple offset butterfly valves, if the design is not correctly calculated and produced, then you would realize that particular designs are not functional. Because of this complex geometry of the seat and seal surface, there would be some design that will experience interference while opening. Since interference is present, this makes the design non-functional. It won't open at all, right? So this is another problem that AI needs to take care of while predicting the best fit valve geometry for us. That's what was happening when I tried to demonstrate you with some angles, some configurations where, let me show you. Yeah, this is it. So for certain configuration, AI is also predicting that this geometry will not produce a functional design. So why to go and see the CV values of this, because it's not going to be operational. So that's also one challenge that AI was solving in our application. Moving ahead, here I have detailed out a comprehensive list of objectives that needs to be satisfied for designing a butterfly valve. But in our current experiment, we haven't picked up strength as that brings in all the complexities of various standards such as API, BSI, ISO. We don't know for which in geography we are in manufacturing this valve. So I have not included the strength part into it. So this is an important slide. Here what we see is all real world problems have to be converted into machine learning problem. So that what it means is, as we saw in the crude level example of machine learning, we need to provide inputs to the machine learning model so that it can learn from it. So for providing inputs, we tried with multiple options. Like what we were doing is, we were trying to ask AI to predict the complete CFD procedure, or let's say the physics behind the pressure drop. So that was a very complex problem to solve. So what we did, we tried with multiple options, like let's reduce the problem by taking snapshots of the cross sections of the valve geometry along the direction of the flow, and try to ask AI to make some sense out of it, why the pressure drop was more in certain case and why the pressure drop was less in some other case. But that did not go so well. We also tried to input the complete numerical CFD results on the discretized fluid volume, the complete fluid volume, as input to AI, and let it figure out why the pressure was dropping more or less in certain cases. But that also did not go well. So we had to come up with multiple solutions, and finally we were able to figure out a very important thread in this whole study. So the major learning that we had in this whole study was that real world problems are too complex in nature. But can every real world problem have a single and direct machine learning solution to it? Our learning was that we need to break down our problem into smaller ones and generate machine learning models for each one of it. Later, we need to combine the results from each machine learning model to fulfill our overall objective. If we recall our problem definition, as I already said, we are expecting AI to figure out almost the complete maths behind CFD, which is not an easy problem for even AI to tackle. So what path we would have taken from here? Let me try to give an example of Gmail here, the Gmail, the mail client, the mail service from Google. As we know, Gmail implements a lot of machine learning in its application. But does Gmail have one single ML model that covers all the requirements of being the greatest emailing service on earth? Not really, isn't it? Gmail uses a lot of machine learning models combined to provide a wonderful experience to its users. For example, the spam filter is one of the ML model, then autocomplete is another, and Gmail also intelligently checks whether you forgot to attach a file or not, and so on. So this is an analogous example, totally altogether a different example, but we also took the same approach in our problem. We divided the problem into smaller ones and created machine learning model for each one of it. As you can see, we made two models for predicting CV itself. One for torque, one for interference, and so on. And at the end, after getting prediction results from all of these problems, all of these models, we go on to predict the result of the overall problem statement, that is finding the one valve design that best fits into all the objectives. This method in machine learning theory is called as ensemble of machine learning models. So the word is ensemble. All right, that's too much of problem definition. Now let's deep dive into our work. As I said, triple offset butterfly valve is a very complex geometry, and it consists of many geometrical parameters. To create a triple offset butterfly valve, you need to model a lot of parameters into your CAD model so as to come up with this final design. Now, for an experimentation purpose, the scope of our project would grow tremendously if we include each one of them. I guess we might end up working on it even after 6 months or a year if we include the effect of each parameter's variation with CV. So what we instead did is we identified the three parameters which were highly influencing the CV. So that are the three offsets basically. For a triple offset valve, the three offsets are the highly influencing parameters for CV. And yes, we were able to achieve results in just a month or two max. So reducing the complexity always works. So what we did is we did the same with concentric butterfly valve and choose these following parameters: the disc thickness, shaft diameter, and its fillet. As we wanted to predict CV for any size of valve with the app, we added a fourth parameter, that was the diameter of the valve, the size of the valve basically. We then identified the geometrical limits of each parameter and split that into a range of 5 steps. So let me show you here. We kept on splitting the ranges to 5 steps, and we got a total configuration of 625, that is 5 per parameter in raised to 4. So we got around 625 parameters. I'm just showing you some 6 to 7 parameters here on the screen. Similarly, the same amount of configurations appeared in triple offset butterfly valve as well. Now, we performed CFD simulation on roughly 600 designs per type of butterfly valve using SimulationHub and calculated their highly accurate CV values. Thanks to SimulationHub's API automation system, we were able to do it all in just 2 hours. Just imagine how much time it would have taken for me to do CFD simulations of 600 geometries on my own using a traditional CFD software. We used these designs and its respective CV data as our ground truth, or say observations that will be provided as input to the machine learning exercise. Let us now have a look at the steps involved in training an ML model. I will pick up the interference detection challenge for triple offset butterfly valve in order to understand a typical machine learning process. So what I'm showing here is the complete design space of the interference dataset that we have generated for those 600 valve designs. If you remember, we had defined geometrical limits to all three parameters under consideration, that is the axial offset, the radial offset, and the cone angle. So this is, this cube represents these the design space altogether. The red dots are the designs that were interferencing, so were not possible to manufacture, and the blue ones are the one that are valid designs. So for AI, this was a pretty simpler problem to solve than CV and CDT, that is just to simply detect the surface where the observations are changing, like from interference to non-interference zone. So this curve detection was the challenge for AI. This is how I numerically provided the input to machine learning algorithm. The observations are basically in the format of either true or false. Was interference detected or not? So this was a big Excel file that went into the machine learning algorithm. And now in machine learning, we need to try out a bit of brute force approach, where we optimize the solution by tuning some parameters of the machine learning algorithms. So our best tuned model delivered an accuracy of almost 98% to that of actual CFD simulation. That's the power of machine learning. We did full CFD simulation of just 600 designs, and now we can predict infinite designs within those fixed geometrical limits with an accuracy of 98%, yes. As we know, machine learning is an iterative process where the algorithms keep on trying to figure out the best fit solution turn by turn. So this is a typical graph of the training accuracy to that of testing accuracy for say 500 iterations. We did the same process for creating ML models of hydrodynamic torque coefficient and CV as well. These graphs show the CFD results of those 600 designs for which we had done the simulations. This one is of CV, this one is for hydrodynamic torque coefficient. So you can see that the selection of those 600 geometries that we did, that was the real crux of the getting a good machine learning model. What we did is we selected such 600 geometries where the design space is equally covered. You won't find less dense regions around the design space. Even for CDT, it's highly covered and equally spaced and highly covered, even for CV. Okay, so let me summarize the process. We provide data to the machine learning algorithm, and then ML trains on that data and produces a neural network, or more commonly what we call is an ML model. Basically, it is a single file. And we use this neural network to predict results on newly available data. So that's all about the project AI powered valve design and how we made it. Let me now take a minute to talk on other AI projects that we do under the banner of CCTech research. One interesting project that we did is finding out high level CAD information from a very basic triangulated mesh geometry. In the current version, you will see that if you upload an STL file of a valve geometry, then in fuse moment, we are able to separate all surfaces based on its surface type, like say planar surface, cylindrical surface, spherical, and so on. So that is also available online for you to try out. We will be sharing the links later on in the slides. Going ahead, we plan to identify further high-level features like holes, threading, nut, and more from just a Valve STL file. We are also working with a couple of SimulationHub customers to display these high-fidelity CFD results generated for their valves, obviously, in augmented reality. Let's say, like, instead of just having a PDF catalog on their website, how about you point out your tablet camera to the website that is loaded on your computer screen and get a detailed rendering of their valve geometry with virtual flow lines and performance data all in a real space. That adds a bit of marketing value to the product. We are also working on some digital twin projects. In this era of Industry 4.0, the advancement of smart valves is inevitable. The more sensor data collected, the more is the opportunity to display it, process it, or say apply AI to it, all in the digital environment. So that's a new direction that we are advancing. All right, let me share some autonomous manufacturing case studies that we are working on these days. The first one is a pretty straightforward for user, but complex in technology type of application, where the user points her mobile camera to a real mechanical part, and using that image, we search a database full of 3D models for a similar CAD model. That's interesting, isn't it? We are also helping oil and gas industry to optimize the production. Not oil and gas industry as such, it's a typo error. Our partners in the oil and gas industry to optimize production using predictive analysis of historical data. We are also working on extracting data intelligently using AI from PDF files, let's say like invoices or purchase orders, reading them properly. Okay, so that brings us to the end of our presentation today. As promised, let me share the details of today's offer. We are providing all the participants a free enterprise account of SimulationHub. We are offering a lot more for free than that standard trial subscription that's available on the website for public. You will be getting free subscription for 2 months instead of the standard 15-day trial. You will be also able to perform flow performance studies on 10 valve designs for free instead of 2 that's available online. We will be also providing you complete onboard training support and technical support as well during this 2 months duration. Now you can opt in for this offer by simply replying to the thank you mail that we will be sending out tomorrow. Feel free to directly reach me anytime on my email for any sort of queries. So this is the website that I was talking about, experiments.cctech.co.in. This website contains most of our research work that we are publishing online. If you want to visit the ML model application, that's available at experiments.simulationhub.com. All right, we are now open for questions. Yeah, there is a question on, can the torque be calculated as well? It's a bit incomplete question, but I assume that it's related to this. Let me just go to the slide. If you're talking about a hydrodynamic torque coefficient, what we provide is hydrodynamic torque coefficient, and using this value and this formula, yes, of course, the torque can be calculated for your own pressure conditions. I hope I was able to answer that question. Let me look at the next question. Yes, there's a question related to I selected only three parameters as input for my multi-objective model. How many such parameters can be taken? Okay, this is a very good question, and this will also expose the power of AI. Let me just go to the slide. What I did is I reduced the complexity for this experimentation purpose to just three parameters. But for real production level applications, AI can support n number of parameters. There is no limit as such to the number of features or the parameters that can be provided to machine learning for training purposes. Let's say like Amazon.in or Amazon.com that we use for our e-commerce website. They use like thousands of properties from every user, and they train up on that. So machine learning has no such limitation of how many parameters that it can train upon. It's just that the development and the training cost increases because we need, the more the parameters we need, the more amount of computational power. That's it. So there is a question on, are we working on any non-invasive flow meters? Let's say for domestic purpose, water uses measurement type of application. Currently, we have not dedicated our platform for flow meters. But we can definitely catch up and connect with you to understand the requirements. And since it's a CFD platform, we can definitely come up with a solution specifically for flow meters in a quick turnaround time. All right, there's a question on machine learning. What class of neural networks did you use, MLPs or CNNs? So CNNs are mostly used in image processing, where data is in a 2D, two-dimensional pixel format. Not even MLPs, we are using standard deep neural networks in this application. We have been working into multiple other type of applications, like if you go for time series type of prediction, you will need RNNs, recurrent neural networks, and LSTMs. So there are many types of applications. Application specific, we need, as per the application demand, we need to come up with the correct algorithm that we need to go ahead with. So we are using a deep neural networks, the standard fully connected deep neural network. Let me ask my colleague if there are many other questions. It's done. Okay, so that's all the questions asked in this slot. I'd say that's the end of the webinar. And for all the European or American friends, I would say have a nice day. And for all the Indian friends, happy, a very good night to you.